Hey guys, your boy Kerpers, and welcome back to my Liverpool Kerma, where last time off he picked up league wins over Manchester United and a Europa League win over some Portuguese team whose name I still don't know how to pronounce. As you can see, yes, that is Manchester United again. I've drawn them in the Capital One Cup, so I'm going back to Old Trafford again for the second video in a row. So, yay! So if you missed the last match, don't worry. Deja vu. Here we go again. I wonder, will Manchester United have the same team out? I will have the same team out, except for one small change. Danny Ings is in instead of Diwak Origi. Daniel Sturridge is actually back, but I'm not going to risk him just yet in case he aggravates his injury. So he'll return at a later point. Return in the next game. At Old Trafford again. It is raining again. It's been raining in pretty much every match I've had in this game and so far. I won't spoil the result of, I'll have to spoil it because I was just about to mention something that would spoil the result. Oh man, I haven't gone with the exact same team. It's Victor Valdez in goal, and Powell is playing in the team. And whereas in the league, they were playing with De Gea in goal and Mata was playing. So, slight changes for Manchester United. But I'm going to have to spoil the result of the league fixture from the last episode. So if you didn't see the last episode, that's great. It was 1-0 to me. Streak of not losing to Manchester United. Is still intact. Which brings a smile to my face, to be honest. Plus, I also want to do well against Manchester United. As always the case, which is added through the undefeated streak. I don't think I've ever not won it. I think I've always deserved the win as well. I never really they give me good games, but I usually always deserve the win, so it's not like I'm winning games that maybe United should have won. It's on the right map. Arango Correa that puts me 1-0 up. It's actually later than the goal that was scored in the league. I scored in the 22nd minute in the league, so 6 minutes later. I'm in front again against Manchester United. Here's the man who actually scored the goal in the league, Gareth Bale. Ings is probably not going to make it. Nope. Straight to Valdez. No Romero. No Sergio Romero. It's Valdez, which is surprising considering Manchester, I have deemed him not good enough for some bizarre reason. Valdez is an amazing keeper, and why many I don't want him as their backup is beyond me. I think it was proven to be a good idea. Yeah, when Romero performed well while the whole De Gea situation was going on. Now that it's solved, De Gea is back in goal for Manchester United. He'll probably move on still, but at least now Man United won't have to worry about him leaving on free because they signed him to a new contract. And now if he is going to leave, they'll get a decent amount for him. And here comes Angel Correa, please, for me. It's Andre Herrera. From Manchester United, the Spaniard was on. He was playing in the league fixture. Pretty good goal there from Manchester United's point of view, but it's been pulled back for the free kick. Valencia. He practically gave it straight to me. That's gone out for my throw. Okay, straight away. Royce sent through Ings. The defense has seemingly gone to sleep. He's there, and he makes it 2-0. That's the problem when you have players, they're all, when they're attacking mine, they forget about the defensive mine. And the counter-attacking football style cuts the United defense like knife through butter, and it's 2-0. Correa doubles his tally. Just like that, in the space of 2 minutes, because it was only 2 games ago I beat Man United 1-0. And now have 3 goals against them in 2 games. Here's Klein. Shaw is giving chase. Klein still has it. Ooh, that almost went in. The deflection, wonder would that have been a Klein goal or would have been a Shaw on goal? Yes, we won't find out. That would have been interesting had that gone in. Showcasing Manchester United's next match against Sunderland. Oh, the pie. Ooh. Very close to becoming, to being my first conceded goal. Probably should have scored, to be honest, if I'm going to be 100% honest with you guys. I probably should have been a goal back from Manchester United, but it could be 3-0. Oh no, good save by Valdez to deny Coutinho. No, and while be careful, you'll rip the freaking jersey off of Coutinho. Oh. Hard to argue that. Laporte does make it 3-0 though. Oh, and I think my your progression in the cup is secured. Laporte with his first goal for the club. Very nice header. Valdez tried his best but he couldn't get to it. Hey, Mata is on. When did he come on? Oh well, it doesn't really matter now. Oh, wait. Doesn't matter who you know they have on. They are going to lose. Correa. Gonna go for the hat trick, Coutinho! Was offside. He was offside. He was Hernandez. Wait, what? Hernandez? Hernandez doesn't play for Manchester United anymore. He moved to Dortmund, wasn't it? Yeah, he moved to Dortmund. That was a permanent transfer, not a loan. It was Yanezai who went on loan. What? They all just... How did they bring on Yanezza? I mean, how did they bring on Hernandez? I mean, it doesn't matter, but what? It's still really confusing. They just brought on a player they don't own anymore. Surely that should have been Anthony Martial. Coutinho aims straight about this. There's the full time whistle. Well, 3-0. Well, progression and secured another win. Two consecutive wins at Old Trafford in the space of three matches. Shocks. No, it looked like everyone was winning. Speaking of winning, I am 1 point clear of Manchester City at the moment. But if I beat Villa, I can increase that. And help me do that is Daniel Sturridge. And he should be fully fit. Yeah, he is. And he will be returning for that game. Oh, you'd get more games than you didn't get much. You got one league game. Granted, there was a international break in between, so it wasn't as bad as first feared injury. promoting Benteke to face his old club, even though Benteke isn't even on my bench, so chances are he probably won't be playing today. Callum Wilson and Raheem Sterling equal on 4 goals each. Very unreliable game is FIFA. Obviously, that's complete bullshit. Raheem Sterling would never score 4 goals in a season. It's only a matter of time before one of my strikers takes the top spot. Right now, Daniel Sturridge is my top goal scorer, I think, with actually, him and Coutinho both have 2. Royce also has 2, if I'm not mistaken. So, all level actually. Looking for Ings! Danny, that was your chance. Sir, get in the box. Okay, you won't. No, Jordan Henderson. He's beaten through the ball. Rodriguez. Royce. Who's in it? Get that. Sanchez. Right on the ball back. But I'm trying to do that. I knocked it out of play for the throw. Coutinho. Looking for Bale. Oh, I'm just about to shoot and then he finally called side. Jesus Christ, seriously. They did all this good stuff with FIFA 16, but they couldn't fix the linesman's timing. It's still rubbish. We're gonna run looking for Coutinho, but okay, gets there first. Or is it O'Care? I think it's O'Kerr. I don't know why I call it okay. I think that was just me being lazy. Coutinho was pretty lazy header. Put some pressure on Goose and he might make a mistake. I went out, didn't I? No? Didn't? Uh-oh. There's Westwood. Back to Richardson. To be careful. Oh, yes! He messed up. Klein. You have to pass it out from the back. Henderson. To Bale. Sturridge. Was trying to pass it to Coutinho, but he felt like he needed to pass it to Sturridge. It's Royce now. Go, Royce. Go, Marco. Go! Go back. Give my headache. Ings! Sturridge! Good save by Guzan. Oh, I was offside. Motherfucker. I'm going to catch a goalkeeper when they're doing that. I just know it. It's just a matter of who will, what goalkeeper it's going to be. Hey, what happened? Oh, it's half time. I wasn't even paying attention to the clock. My focus is on the ball. Don't worry about that. I think if come the 55th minute or something like that, I'm still nil-nil, I might bring on Correa. Unless Ings can get something for me. This is your chance, go Danny, go! Oh, you almost won a pen? Oh! Very close there. For the defender, I want to be careful. Well, if he had caught me, Ings would have gone down. It would have been a penalty. Eaten. I don't know, would I have been last man? Probably wouldn't have been a red. I'd say it probably would have been a yellow, but a red, I don't think so. It didn't look like the last man. Have to watch it back. Okay, Ings, you didn't do your job. So here comes Correa. Coutinho is a bit tired, so I'm going to bring on Firmino as well. Klein. And really, Jordan? Really? Did that just seriously happen? Go, start, go! Henderson. Henderson corner. Nathaniel Klein. Ooh. Nathaniel Klein almost got it. It in. I think it's in our corner. Yep, sure is. Carlos Rodriguez, Roberto Firmino. Go Firmino, go! Oh, Richards got lucky there. Klein? I mean, Klein, to tell you. Ah! Well, I was going to say, I was preparing to say, yeah, I was inclined to tell you I was going to score, but I didn't, so I didn't say that. But. Klein? Klein? Yes! Nathaniel Klein! I've been saying his name over and over again, but finally it's come to fruition. Nathaniel Klein, probably the most unlikeliest of goal scorers. Because saying that, he did score against us. So, it's not that unlikely, but you wouldn't. He's probably the least likely person you'd expect. Well, one of. It's rare to see defenders get a goal. Well, but I don't care because he got the goal that will get me the 3 points at this point in time. They've been very shut up shop, but they will have to go for it now. Unless they're happy to lose to me. Could be the case. Correa! Can you make it two? Ooh, if he made it two. Klein. Correa. Mikal Richards is up there, and so is Hutton. Villa's defense has abandoned poor Brad Guzan. Ooh, if I'd gotten that ball to one of my strikers, could be looking at 2-0. Because Villa's forwards, Villa's defenders had all gone upfield. They're all back now. Carlos Rodriguez. Correa! Ooh! That corner or a throw? A corner. Sturridge! Ooh! Hill could probably. Nope. I was gonna say he might initiate a counter attack. To maybe save a point, but that's not gonna happen because the referee blew up straight away as soon as he cleared the ball. So, with a game in hand, I have a 4-point lead. Very nice, huh? Next game is against Norwich Pitch. Look at the table. Crystal Palace are last. Very unlikely. Bottom three. Because Swansea and West Ham are both doing very well in real life. And saying that, Liverpool aren't doing well in real life, so not very much can be said about that. Only two teams yet to lose in this in the league. It's Liverpool and Chelsea. Southampton are the only team without a win. Oh, wait. No, I retract that statement. Swansea and Crystal Palace don't have wins. So three teams are winless, and two teams have yet to lose. And I think I'm the only team with a draw. Because I have a perfect record of 6 games and 18 points. 10 goals for, none against. Sterling now has 5 goals. Right. And I wasn't very impressed with Ings in that last match. I'm gonna start Correa against Norwich. Yeah. Other than that, I think we're done. So it's currently... So I'm currently being hunted down by both the blue and red sides of Manchester. West Brom sitting fourth, with all the London teams just on, just outside, waiting for the opportunity to come into the top four. With Spurs in fifth, Chelsea in sixth, and Arsenal out to the top seven. But the main thing is, I'm in first, I have a game in hand. And in the next episode, I'll have games against Norwich and the second group game in the Europa League. Until then, thanks for watching, hope you enjoy.